Hey, and welcome back to this series that is going to follow me from a complete novice filmmaker to, well, I don't know that yet. But if you are considering a career change of your own, then this could be a great source of inspiration of what you can do and possibly a good example of what not to do. And if you haven't watched episode one, then make sure to do that first. I think I'm staying around. What is they talking about? I'm not gonna be able to go out and get real life clients in this period now because of travel and quarantine and all that, but I'm not gonna be lazy. What I've been watching so much of lately on YouTube is product videography tutorials where people create ads from the comfort of their own homes, and I like being home and working on projects, so that's definitely something I want to add to my repertoire and what I'm going to do, try to do for brands down the line as well. So I'm using this period to just practice. So just setting up a studio as best as I can with the gear I have and try to create some spec ads. A spec ad is an ad you just do for yourself and not for another brand. And that's something you gotta do a lot in the beginning as a filmmaker, and that I also expect to do a lot of. Oh, and if a representative from a City Racha production company watches this, then feel free to use the video. And I know it's not the highest quality because I'm a beginner, but I will accept payments in the form of your delicious sauce. Okay, this is pretty cool. That clothing store that I made the video for 2-3 weeks ago now, they posted the video again on their Instagram story. And I wasn't satisfied with that video at all, so I'm pretty impressed that they posted it. So that's hopefully a good foundation for us to work together next year as well. But there is in fact more updates from today, in addition to this beautiful mustache hair. It sucks being on the metro these days, so I have to cover it up with a facial mask. Enough complaining. What I was gonna say is that when I was out getting those two other jobs that I've already told you about in episode one, I also went into a store that sells all kinds of different beers and tonic waters for like drinks and stuff. So like with the other stores, I offered them a free video. So we made a deal and I was gonna come by the following Monday. And then the Monday came, I went down there, brought all my gear, and 5 minutes went and nothing happened. I was just standing outside, the shop was closed. And then 15 minutes went by, and then 20 minutes. And then finally, after a little over 20 minutes, I got a message on Instagram where he told me that I forgot that we were gonna film and we're not opening this early today. So that's when I learned that if they don't pay, they're not as invested, obviously, but really figuratively and literally, they don't care as much. But the pretty cool thing is that now after 3 weeks, they wrote back to me on Instagram and asked if I could make a video for their web store. So that in itself is a pretty good testament to that if you just go out there and leave an impression on people, then you might be rewarded. So now they need a video and they don't have to Google or anything because there is one person on their mind when it comes to making video, and that's that random guy who just came by knocking and was eager to create a free video for them. Look no further. A lot of talk in this video, but this series is about doing and showing you the encounters with these clients that I'm talking about. So I look forward to rather showing you this in the future videos. Thanks for watching. Hey, hop in a whip and I'm out. I need so much I can count. Oh, and I don't need no college, cause I'm getting stupid amounts. Yeah, I'm getting stupid amounts. Hey, so much that I'm losing the counts. Hey.